So this land really enters my paintings. It's really unique. A lot of old history here. And we had the Indians and we had people that go way back. There's so many stories around here that Rose Hill is, I'm kind of glad to get away from it, you know. Actually, really glad to take the burden off me. Nice to visit, but I would never, for one moment, did I ever want to live there again. Rose Hill Mansion was built by my great-grandfather's brother, William K. Strong, in 1839. The Historical Society bought three-quarters of the house in 1966, and in 1981 our family moved out of there, and now it's a museum. It was a huge mansion with 24 large rooms, you know. Just a tremendous amount of work to keep the place up. And on the other hand, there was the good side I get having ingrained in me, you know, living in the past. You know. When I was a kid, I would see imaginary friends. I would be in a Civil War battle. I'd play north or south, but mostly south. You know. Living at Rose Hill, she was burdened with an awful lot of work. And my father was very ambitious. Here I am 40 years later, just like in the picture. They had that 53 Plymouth in the background. That was our family car. We rode up from Richmond, Virginia to here in 1958. And when we came here, the house was pretty shabby. There wasn't any paint on the house or anything. They've done a beautiful job of restoring this place. I think it was my father's main mission to restore this house. And if he hadn't have, I doubt if anybody would have saved it. It wasn't in very good shape. In the Civil War, I think it was a time when people had a direction, everyone had a direction in life, maybe knew what their purpose was. There was the glory of being a hero, you're bonded together. People were bonded together to save their land, you know. Once the flag was lost, you know, they captured the flag of the enemy. It may sound like a game, but I mean, they were done. Once their flag was captured, they were done. It was a time that never has happened before and will never happen again, that we were divided up. So it was a very complex time, you know. Yeah, right now is I've really changed, and I feel like a true blue. And I really thought about my ancestors, and some that were involved very much in the Underground Railroad in my mother's side. And before this, you know, I went south, you know, and I've come to that realization. My roots belong in the north, and I'll never go south again. I don't want to be stuck in one subject, you know. Don't want to be too much of a fanatic about one thing. Sometimes I need to go beyond that and get a different taste. It's like having a different flavor. And that's what my new paintings are about. Sending it all out there because lots of people are going to see these things. I chose the title of Pinhole Perspective. If you look through a small hole, you can see a whole room and see everything. It's the way I look at the world. Just a little dot, but here I'm here and there with my pictures. I'm just I feel rich, you know, really grandiose. Saw the movie The Trumpet Player, and Kirk Douglas, he was trying to reach the highest note, a higher note than anyone ever was ever to accomplish, you know. He could never do it, you know? And that's what I'm trying to do, go higher and higher. There's no end to it.